The clash of the titans when Sarah and Craig prepare to work together again and try to put the past firmly behind them in Shortland Street.
Brenda, are you going to shaft Mrs. Warner and take her job?
I might have to.
Still, your colleagues were finding it difficult to cope with what was being asked of them.
They were being put at risk. Some of the patients. I tried to talk to Tony so much.
Your nursing manager?
Yes, my concerns were ignored.
I'll get hold of Garth this morning, see if we can't find some way to gag her. At the very least, we need to fire some warning shots at the TV people.
Sure.
Hey, don't let this get to you. We'll sort it.
Yeah, it just hurts, that's all.
Yeah, when someone you think is your friend shafts you. From now on, it's gloves off. Brenda is going to get everything that is coming to her.
I knew she was struggling. I should have taken her more seriously.
Well, that whole poor me thing was just an act. This is out and out mutiny.
I shouldn't have let things get this out of hand.
The important thing now is you taking control and putting Brenda on as short a leash as possible. We'll get things in motion. Show her who's boss.
You're right. Thanks.
Food will go here and the chill out zone's over there, so that's where we'll put the couches.
Proto has confirmed.
Are you serious?
No freaking way.
Way. He had another gig, but I'm paying more, so this is going to be the best party of the summer. I can't wait.
Oh, light beer, yummy.
On the deck in the tub, and you can go out for ice later.
Who are you, and what have you done with my nice, sweet, polite daughter?
Oh, not that gross. Stick it in the cupboard. The caterer's doing drinks where you don't need them.
Food and drinks? For how many?
50 to 70?
And their partners.
I thought we discussed this.
You discuss. Sophie ignored.
Well, Sophie can just unignore and uninvite a few people. We agreed 50 tops. My credit card, remember?
Guys, we really need to get these lights sorted. Hunter's exaggerating, Dad. It's just a few friends from school. I promise there'll be nothing to worry about.
Oh, I know, because I'm sticking around to make sure that is the case. Don't worry, you won't even know I'm there.
I'm not going to that loser's party.
Well, technically, it's not actually Hunter's party.
Well, how do you know that?
I heard some people talking about it at school yesterday. Sophie's in charge of the invite list.
Which means wall-to-wall Paris Hilton clones and tragic wannabes.
Stella and Beth are going, and James and Cooper.
Really?
Yeah. I might check it out too, you know, just for a while or something.
Why? When you know how much of a dick Hunter is.
Well, it's the only party on this weekend. And they've got a really good DJ.
I'm not going to Hunter's place.
It's just a fling, right? It's not like he hates you. Does it really matter if you see him?
You so want to go.
Why not? It's still you and me hanging out together, but there'll be great music and drinks we don't have to pay for. And boys. We so need some boys in our lives.
And yes.
Good.
Oh, yeah. Whole baked salmon with lime cream and tiger prawns. Tempting? A cold, crisp salmon.
Whole salmon, wow.
Specially prepared and served by your favorite chef. Naked.
Cool. Hey, did you see this? Some elder reckons welfare payments to Maori families should be cut.
Oh, yeah, I read the headlines.
Our people are too dependent on handouts. We should say no to state charity. Yeah, and then who feeds the kids?
I just want to feed you.
Don't you care about this stuff?
Babe, it's my day off. I just want to chill with my girl.
Yeah, but this is crazy. If there was no welfare safety net, then what, would all the beneficiaries just suddenly go out and get jobs, sort out their drug and alcohol problems, straighten up and fly right?
You are so hot when you're angry.
I just think it's irresponsible.
Babe, I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to talk at all.
We'll never talk about this stuff.
Yes, but actions speak louder.
But this is important.
So is this. Come here.
There's been a theatre reshuffle, which unfortunately means that your surgery won't be happening today. In fact, probably not till next Wednesday.
Oh, what?
Two critical patients just arrived in ED. It's life or death, so they get priority. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I bet.
Go the health system, eh?
Yes, I sympathise. Yes, it's unfair. I'm sorry.
I know that you've got all this Brenda TV stuff to deal with, but this is important too. I mean, Tony, it's an inguinal hernia. How hard can it be to fit him in somewhere?
I agree 100%, but the surgeons have made the call and we have to do what we're told.
He comes to us to get better and we stress him out and send him away sicker.
We all have to do things we don't like. It's called the real world. Has he got any money?
No. And no way of getting home to Tauranga.
Check with the Ambos. If we've had a transfer from down there, someone might be heading back. It's a long shot.
Guess it's worth a try. Thanks.
I'm looking for Brenda Holloway and Tony Warner.
Brenda's working downstairs at the moment. I'm Tony Warner, and you are?
Joanne Hill, from the New Zealand Nurses Association.
I'm guessing this is about the TV item last night.
It raised some serious issues that need to be discussed.
Of course. We have a very tight schedule today.
And every day, I'm sure. But there are clearly problems here that shouldn't be left to fester. Now, where can we talk? What we're most concerned about is the lack of communication on your part. To learn third hand that we were deliberately shut out of a crisis situation...
That is not the case. The problem was handled efficiently in-house.
Under your direction?
Yes.
By continuing to operate at capacity with half the usual number of staff?
No. Yes.
When you don't have adequate staffing levels, you should be shutting down beds.
Yes, but we can't predict the number of admissions we'll have in any given day.
So you compromise by pushing staff to the limit and providing patients with inadequate care?
Our treatment was not inadequate. The workload put a strain on our team, but we managed.
Did you attempt to hire more staff?
I took on several new grades, yes.
But no experienced nurses?
I did, but...
But not soon enough to prevent burnout and exhaustion. Or, in Brenda Holloway's case, a potentially fatal car accident.
I regret that, obviously, but if you're trying to suggest...
I'm trying to establish whether you, as nursing manager, were aware that the situation had reached crisis point.
Of course I was. This isn't exclusive to Shortland Street, this problem. It's happening right through the country. It's unfair to single us, me, out.
Thank you for your time. I'll see Brenda now.